The reviews are in for Ang Lee's sci-fi action film Gemini Man, and they are surprising. The film stars Will Smith as a professional killer who's inexplicably being pursued by a younger version of himself. And so far, most critics are saying they enjoyed the visual effects but found the story to be severely underwhelming. As you may recall, Twitter lit up with praise for Gemini Man after the film was first screened for critics in September.
I make this look good.
But not so fast. It looks like critics who disliked the film held off on sharing their opinions until writing their actual reviews. And unfortunately, it seems like most critics fall directly into that category.
No! No!
Sadly, yes. The film, which has been in development for the better part of two decades, struck most reviewers as being all spectacle and no substance. This is particularly surprising considering that Ang Lee directed the film, and he has numerous Academy Awards under his belt. Over the years, he's demonstrated that he can bring a special, decidedly human touch to even the most CGI-heavy blockbuster. Take 2003's Hulk, for example. So, what went wrong with Gemini Man? Judging by the reviews, quite a bit. Critics say the plot is too thin, the characters are undercooked, the dialogue induces groans galore, and the central gimmick, that is, the conflict between the two Smiths, ends up falling rather flat. In his 2-star review, The Guardian's Peter Bradshaw writes that, "...the digital novelty is striking for the first 10 minutes, silly for the next 10 minutes, and by the end of the movie you're pining for the analog values of script and direction. A wittier, smarter riff on everything could have saved this." As for Lee's decision to shoot the film at a high frame rate, Bradshaw writes, "...the technique creates a new pin-sharp clarity, but at the expense of making the film look like video, or like a celluloid movie on a plasma TV when you haven't deactivated motion smoothing. It's not a taste I want to acquire." Variety's Peter DeBruges was keen on reminding everyone that Gemini Man spent several years languishing in development hell, and he suspects there's a very good reason for that. Gemini Man was a nearly impossible project to get made, falling through multiple times because the technology wasn't there yet. At least, that's been the excuse. Although judging by the finished product, it was the script that never lived up to the promise of its premise. If there's a common theme among the film's many detractors, it's that Gemini Man will likely be remembered as a fine technical achievement that ultimately suffers from a supremely half-baked script. In the words of CNET's Richard Trenholm, "...it's genuinely impressive when Smith as we know him goes face-to-face, and even hand-to-hand, with the digitally de-aged mid-20s model. Unfortunately, it ends up as an unengaging tech demo, because the characters and storyline seem to have been given barely a fraction of the thought that's gone into the effects." Even some of the positive reviews take the film to task for its lazy writing. Abby Bernstein of Assignment X writes that, "...the film boasts what is arguably the best use of 3D since Avatar. This makes it all the more disappointing to report that the screenplay is pretty standard science fiction fare. It's moderately entertaining, but neither director Lee's visual pizzazz nor the commitment of the actors can keep the story from being predictable and feeling familiar." Black Film's Wilson Morales agreed, "...the story is not original, but the visual and action sequences rock. With so much time given the longevity to getting greenlit, surely some of the money spent on the technology could have gone to the writers to punch up the script." The Hollywood Reporter's Stephen Dalton was particularly merciless in his review, writing that, "...the hyper-real look of Gemini Man is immersive and richly detailed, but it also has the disconcerting effect of making a big-budget cinematic spectacle look like a vintage videotaped TV drama. To steal a line from Dolly Parton, it takes a lot of money to look this cheap."
I think I done just got mad.
Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite movies are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.